Hey folks, Gilberto from Snowflake here. Did you know you can query Snowflake directly from VS Code? Let me show you how. Okay, if you want to follow along, you're going to need a couple of things. The first is, you guessed it, VS Code. And the second is a Snowflake account. A trial account will work just fine, and I encourage you to create one if you haven't already done so. Let's get started. First, navigate to the command palette in VS Code. You can find it in the View menu. Search for, or select, Extensions. It's the first option for me, so I will go ahead and click it. And next, search for Snowflake. Click on the first result and open up the extensions page. You can see here that the verified publisher is Snowflake, so this is the correct extension. Let's install it. Great, so once it's installed, you'll see the icon for the extension appear within VS Code. If you click on the icon, you should see an authentication modal, and here you can log into your Snowflake account. To log into your account, you'll need your Snowflake account URL. I'm already logged into Snowflake using Snowsight, and I can find the account URL there. If I navigate to the bottom left of my account, hover over the current account, clicking on this icon here will copy the account URL to the clipboard. I'll navigate back to VS Code and paste that in. I'm now prompted for my username and password, so I will go ahead and enter those and click sign in. Great, I'm in. Let me give you a quick tour of the UI. On the right, you'll notice some menus to set your context. You can set your role, database, schema, and warehouse here. Underneath that, you'll see the Database Explorer. This will let you browse the databases, schemas, and tables in your account. Finally, below that is a query history window, which will show some queries that you've run. We haven't run any, so let's go ahead and run some queries. Let's start by setting our context up above. I'll use a Snowflake sample data database, and I'll choose this schema here. I'll leave the warehouse untouched. Now let's explore this database in the Database Explorer. So we can see there are 24 tables. Expand that. I'm going to click on the call center table. You'll see that the object details window will open up. This will let you inspect the object. And here you can see more information about the call center table, like the columns and their data types. If you want to preview the data in the table, click the preview icon and you open a preview of the data. But the fun thing is, of course, to run queries. So let's click on the query icon here. And this will open a file where you can start writing SQL queries. Here's a very simple query just to demonstrate this functionality. To run this query, you can click this button up to the right, or you can hit Command Return on a Mac. And great, there it is. You can view the query results down here in another window at the bottom, and the corresponding query can be found in the query history. Try out the extension and let us know what you think by dropping a comment below. For more information, check out the links in the description, and I would also love it if you could like and subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.